This new work is a beautiful marriage of AI and human ingenuity, and I am loving it. And it has a self-healing underwear too. Yeah, I know. I'll try to explain it. So, what is this? Well, when you see someone dressed so sharply that even your GPU blushes in real life or in a game like Cyberpunk, and you're thinking, I wish I could look like that. Possible? Yes! With image to 3D models, you can turn a picture into a 3D person. Problem solved? Kind of, but not really. This is from only 5 years ago, and it's quite rough. No thanks. Now, today, we can do way better. Good enough for us to actually recognize the problem. Oh boy. These reconstructions usually glue the clothes and the body into one thing. Sure, it's one piece, but unless you want to become a demon and, oh goodness, worse, a demon that is almost naked, then this is not for you. It also has other problems, since the body and clothes are not separated, no simulation. Did you hear what I just said? No simulation! Can't do the 2 minute papers thing. You can't make it flutter, wrinkle, when your hero does a cool spin. I am about to cry. So, the dream of true digital fashion, physics-ready, wearable, separable garments, God almighty, I only want the clothes, and this remains out of reach. Until now. Get this, this new paper from UCLA and the University of Utah claims that from just a single photo, it can reconstruct not just a 3D human, but physically accurate, simulation-ready clothes separated and ready to move. Ooh, bold claim. Why? Because this is one of the hardest problems in virtual human modeling. A geometry, a physics, and an AI nightmare all at once. So, good luck. Okay, so how does this work? Well, you see, in goes your image, then it guesses an initial sewing pattern. It's like a digital tailor cutting fabric pieces based on what it sees. Then, those flat panels are thrown onto a 3D human model. And, oof, I'm sorry, but this is not even close. The man's clothes are all over the place. Let's try another one. Wow. This is somehow even worse. This is a fitted t-shirt. The output is not even close. And the skirt needs to go below the knee and is not shaped like this at all. This is a total disaster. Not working at all. But wait, we are not done yet. Now, this system uses differentiable physics and multi-view diffusion guidance to refine the shapes of the sewing panels. That means it adjusts the curves and seams so that the simulated garment better matches the character. Okay, let's try that on. Oh my! Ha! Now we're talking. But the textures are still missing. This is just the shape. Not a problem. Then the system looks at the input image again and paints the correct material and color on the 3D garment. Okay, I say this is ready for simulation. Now, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, and let's see. Holy mother of papers! That looks absolutely incredible! And not only that, but these characters also have some incredible dance chops. So, how does it do all this magic? Well, it is explained in the paper in detail, but this is for experts. Well, I am not that, but I'll try my best to explain it to you, and I promise, it gets properly insane. Let's dive in. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2 Minute Papers with Dr. Carol Zsolnai-Fehér. Dr. Carol. First, the AI part. They use something called multi-view diffusion guidance. You show the model one picture, and it imagines what you'd look like from every angle. Left, right, back, top. As if the AI walked around you taking photos. It's basically an AI fashion paparazzi, but one that doesn't shout your name while you're eating. No, no. Instead, you can think of it like a team of tiny artists walking in circles around the mannequin, each one sketching what they think they see, and then arguing until they all agree on a consistent shape. And now comes the human ingenuity part. Here is the secret weapon. Codimensional incremental potential contact. if you want to sound really cool. Just call it CIPC and disregard the blank stare of that poor cashier in Costco. Bonus points if you explain this energy term to them while buying socks. Okay, so what do all these hieroglyphs do? This is a beautiful optimization-based cloth simulator. The math is so good, it's frightening. We are talking about minimizing something called the total system energy. Now, what does that mean? In plain terms, it's like the universe trying to find the most comfortable resting position for every thread in the fabric. The first term keeps the cloth near where it was supposed to be, the second makes it elastic and bend nicely, and the last one, the barrier term, screams, "Don't you dare penetrate the body with the clothes." We've seen that problem before, and those results are unusable. And this is not fake physics, it is fully differentiable. That means the AI can feel how wrong it is and learn which way to pull or stretch each seam to fix it. Imagine the tailor not just seeing the mistake, but feeling the tug on the fabric and adjusting instantly. Wow! So the AI part, multi-view diffusion, tells the system what it should look like, and the human ingenuity part, CIPC, tells it how it should behave in the real world. And together, they turn a single image into a beautiful, simulation-ready digital outfit. So, a really advanced paper explained in a way anyone can understand. I hope. I am trying my best here. But the paper is of course not perfect. For instance, I think the sleeve is way too long here. And that is one of the few weak points of this method. It is brilliant, but it still struggles with out-of-distribution fashion. If you wear something exotic, like a feather jacket or a jellyfish costume, I know you do that, don't deny it, the AI just sighs, gets a drink, and sews with its eye closed. And it really shows. It feels like the AI says, I'll fix it tomorrow. Human-like intelligence? Checkmark. But you know what? I'll still take it over this naked demon. Yuck. And this work was written by a bunch of legends in computer graphics. These are the same brilliant minds behind the incremental potential contact model that keeps digital fabrics from clipping through bodies and exploding into chaos. We talked about this approximately 500 paper videos ago. These folks are the quiet heroes of physics-based animation, and almost nobody talks about them. Works like these are like endangered species of research. Complex, beautiful, and absolutely essential to make all this magic happen. And we are trying to give these works a voice, because if we don't do it, I am heartbroken to say, but no one else will. So, before I tell you about this weird self-healing underwear, please like, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and leave a really kind comment. And you can also help us save more papers. Join our Patreon, get early access, and your name in the credits below. Every supporter keeps the dream alive for beautiful works like this. Okay, so I'm a bit reluctant to show you this weird underwear, but I'll do it. For science. The system doesn't just optimize the sewing pattern, no, it can re-sew the clothes mid-process when things go wrong. Everywhere else, if the cloth mesh tangles, the whole simulation explodes. But here, when that happens, the AI tailor calmly pulls it back, irons it out, and refits it on the digital body, all automatically. So it takes a while, about 2 hours for the whole process. But it was impossible to do well before, and now it is possible. Wow! And it's one of the reasons why their system can finish on a single RTX 3090 GPU without collapsing into a polygonal disaster. So, from threads to fabrics, AI tailors, without any wardrobe failures, subscribe to 2-Minute Papers. On November 4th and 5th in London, the Weights and Biases Fully Connected Conference returns. Yes! Join top AI engineers for 2 days of agent building and model training. It's a fantastic opportunity for networking and learning. perfect for AI developers, researchers, and business leaders. Yes, that is you, fellow scholars. And here's the best part. You can get tickets at 20% off. Just click the link in the video description and use the code to claim your discount today.